Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial. So guys, today I'll be going to discuss how I learned data science that has been extremely popular and will explain how I would learn data science if I had to start again from absolutely ground zero. As many of my subscribers were asking what are the different steps to learn data science, or they are not sure from where to start because on internet there is so much overwhelming information. Or if you are someone who is not from technical field and you have doubts that you don't know programming, then how can you learn data science? Things have definitely changed since the start of my data science journey. So I want to provide a current step-to-step roadmap for this learning process. Hopefully, this video will provide you a clear path to shape their own data science journey. And please watch this video till the end as I'll give you a few of my best tips and free resources to actually stick with this plan. And guys, if you enjoy this video, please hit that like button and feel free to subscribe for more content similar to this. Also remember to turn on notifications to be alerted when I post my next video. So guys, now question is, what is the first thing you need to learn? Well, let's step back a bit. So in terms of becoming a data scientist, first thing I would suggest you to figure out what is the data science or data scientist, as it doesn't mean the same thing to one person versus what it means to other person. And the same stands for the companies as well that are hiring for the position of data scientist. So in some companies, a data scientist is considered as a developer plus data scientist, while in other company, they consider business analysts as data scientists. So keeping that in mind, you first have to figure out where exactly do you want to be, because data science is very vast field, so you may have lost in that. Now, when you are familiar with your niche, first thing you need to learn is statistics. And I know a lot of people start with Python that are absolutely okay, but Python and R is a tool to apply data science. It's not the data science itself. So if you really want to learn, I would suggest first start with statistics, then of course you can add more to that. So guys, here I'll obviously give you the topics, and those will be very basics that you have already learned during your schooling. So you don't have to go into the advanced statistics. So you need to be familiar with probability, mean median mode, distributions, and mainly normal distributions, standard deviation and variance, plots and graphs like QQ plot, box plot, and so on. And the last but not the least, gradient descent. And even you can find out a video of mine on that. I have attached the link into the description. Next, coming to programming. Most people do this either in Python or R. You are free to start with either one, but generally prefer Python. It's also more commonly asked for in job description. And as I said, Python, I believe it's a bit versatile. So guys, at last I'll let you know free resources for all what I'm telling you right now, so that you don't have to pay to anyone and you can understand the concepts as well. Over time, I have had a change of opinion about how much foundational knowledge you need to learn data science after experience many different types of learning myself. I found learning by doing real world projects is the most effective way to grasp this field. Now, coming to data part. So guys, before jumping to any algorithm, we first need to understand the data. How can we extract useful information from data? How can we utilize the portion of data and neglect the rest of the part? How can we know about the trend in data and many more such things? So here, data analysis and visualization part come into the picture. So here your focus should be on learning NumPy, pandas, and visualization libraries like matplotlib, seaborn, plotly, etc. These packages allows you to do the data cleaning and exploration, because in data science field, 70% of time and effort goes into molding the data into useful stuff before building any working model. So it's most important thing to grasp the knowledge of NumPy, pandas, and visualization libraries. So guys, Once you are good with statistics, Python programming, and data analysis, now it's time to jump into machine learning, deep learning, computer vision, or NLP. So guys, if you are targeting for data analyst, then machine learning is not that much needed. But if you are looking for data scientist, then after data, it is the topmost priority. So let me give you topics for machine learning. So guys, there are three divisions in machine learning: supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. So under supervised learning, different regression and classification algorithms come, what you can see on the screen. And I have made a video on these as well. You can find out the link into the description. For unsupervised learning, you have to understand few clustering algorithm, and coming to reinforcement learning, so you can see few algorithms for that as well on the screen. Now, when you learn machine learning, you will find this difficulty that you will come across lot of maths and statistics concepts. So here, instead of going back to mathematics books and try solving the problem on paper, I'll recommend you to work on your own projects and explore other people's code work while learning these concepts online. As you go along learning this way, you will see when different people use algorithms and different packages. I recommend compiling a list of all the different things you see. You should go through the source code of all these different things and try to grasp how they are constructed. Frankly speaking, guys, if you can understand the source code for an algorithm, you functionally understand the maths behind it. It's still good to supplement this information with some actual theory using Wikipedia or some math textbooks. You can check any project over the Kaggle, and that is absolutely free. Now, coming to deep learning. So deep learning is all about the neural network, where you have to deal with huge amount of data with more complexities. So it starts with artificial neural network, and then we move on to convolutional neural network, which is mainly used for image processing. And then we move to recurrent neural network, which is basically used for text related problems. Guys, once you are done with all these, you can try understanding server, Docker, and deployment activities so that you can work end to end in the industry. The data science journey is never over. You know, honestly, you will constantly be learning and applying new things, but I personally think that that's what makes the professional really fun. So guys, as I promised that I'll let you know few free materials for learning these concepts. So here it is. Guys, there are countless online courses, YouTube videos, certificates, degree programs, etc. And it will be really hard to figure out where to start and which ones are right for you. Okay, so first online course that I would recommend are the Kaggle micro courses. These courses are very good for learning machine learning, deep learning, and Python concepts. I personally think the best way to learn data science in general is going through other people's Kaggle's workbook and eventually writing your own concepts or projects. Now, second course I'll recommend, Google Machine Learning Crash Course, as Google has been pretty heavily into education space since the introduction of Google Colab a few years ago. So guys, just to let you know, if you are not familiar with Google Colab, it's an awesome tool that lets you run a Jupyter notebook in the web browser and actually use Google Compute resources for free. Guys, last course I'll recommend, Andrews Ng's deeplearning.ai. This is the best course for understanding the concepts of deep learning. And for statistics, you can definitely consider Khan's Academy course. And for Python, either you can refer Geeks for Geeks or Fast AI. They have explanation as well as solution for each stated problems with the coding. So guys, I have attached links of all these courses. You can go through that or add your comment if anything else is required. It took me more than 5 years to really understand these concepts, and I'm still learning on day-to-day basis. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.